got married. Luckily, I married in another very strong family, church family. And my wife, Anyabuike, was the first daughter of my parents-in-law. So, as the church program, we married as virgins. I married at the age of 28. And she was 26. She was a virgin. I was too. That's why I say, she may do the prof. It's my first shot. So, I think my wife was very brilliant. Two of us were teachers. We had our high elementary certificate the same year. And we struggled to bring up children. So, I'm surprised that my daughter Chinedum would be so brilliant. When she was young, I was in the university. University of Ibadan. My wife took the effort of bringing up my children. When she was a teacher, she brought them very, very well and concentrated on mathematics and English. She would flog them and punish them properly to ensure that they were very good students. We had 12 children. I know I was brilliant. My wife was equally brilliant. That's why all my children were brilliant. You can just imagine how I feel having a brilliant girl. As young as she was, she went to the best of institutions from secondary school. She went to the Federal Common College in Ugu. It was a highly competed institution. People were competing, and they could get them, only the brilliant ones could get entry to the school. She passed it. And one story about it that in the publication, that time they used to publish the results on the pages of the paper. And on that paper, they published the result, published her number. Used another name by either by typographical error, so gave that number another name, the name of a boy. When I was the university, my wife said, no way, there's no way that her child shouldn't pass this exam. And she was really careful, she wrote through the result, saw her number. But some other person's name, they wrote to me about what happened, so I never. So I came down, I went to know. The principal of that college met me, and I told him why I came in. He said, well, he gave me the list, I said, yes, look at this number. This number is my father's number. See, I said, what of the person? He said, I've already admitted the boy. So what of the number of mine? What I said, well, they have a limited number. They can't increase, but they have to refer to the lawyer or something like that, so that they bring the papers or something like that. Anyway, in fact, they were not ready to admit me, and the parents said, never. She must be admitted. Maybe in the office, I don't know what went through. Eventually, they admitted her and gave her two institutions, one in the Enugu and the Enugu. I said, she has to take one. She took that of Enugu. And she went to school and did very, very well. Her school certificate was very good. From there, she was the first in my family among the children. As the first child, she did very, very well. And I was the first to go to university. So when the result for entering to the university came, she was admitted to the University of Ife. She was given to study pharmacy. And in that school, pharmacy was the most difficult subject. But she was passing my exams easily. I was able to get any hiccup anywhere because she was brilliant. Not only that she was brilliant, she was very well behaved. Very, very well behaved. And there, she showed she was really one of the academic giants, which she is now. The signs were there. So you see, I didn't even know by these days parents would negotiate for their children how to enter into the university. Any trouble which she wanted in my past were admitted. So I'm very happy. I was surprised that she, I think God knows what he put in her. She was very good, morally wonderful. My daughter never disobeyed me for any day except one thing. When she went to the university, she joined the Christian clubs and societies and met now her husband. She told me that she came home and told me that somebody was, you know, seeking her hand for marriage. I said, well, she said, somebody said, from myself, from me, I said, no, I tell you the truth. I said, never, never. I was doing myself a bit. I said, you remember, no, we are never good friends. We are not good friends. We can't be there. Yeah, I was there. I've been there for a long time. I don't like them. They don't like me. I didn't say I don't like them anyway, but the situation, I had no friends there anyway. Though at the end I had one wonderful friend, Shadi. So my daughter almost died because I refused. This is the only thing I told her she refused. She bottled up. I was pining away because I didn't allow her to marry the man. I didn't know until we went for a wedding in Lagos here, wedding of one of our relations. I saw my daughter, my pretty daughter. She was almost, she was so emaciated. Hey, I left the wedding, I called her, my daughter, what's your problem? Was anybody else, and I was thinking of so many things, I know that she was raped or had been pregnant, or anything. But I said, or a poison. Well, why are you like this? She said, are you sick? She said, no. Do you feel well? She said, yes. But why are you like this? You're not looking well. Tell me your problem. You know, I know I'm not a rich man, but you know what? I will spend anything for your education. Tell me. If it is money, I'll go and borrow. She said, no. She didn't tell me anything. I urged and forced her to tell me. Then it came to me. I said, is it because I see you shouldn't marry Collins? She said, yes. I said, my God. For me to lose my daughter because of, please, 100% go in for her, for me. I have accepted. She jumped up. She was so happy. Luckily, they got married. And today, the husband is a bishop. Okay. My daughter continued telling me that the Ministry of Education, that department is so difficult. Many people have been sent away because of non-performance. But you person, she said, yes, it was this difficult too. You are equal to the task. God be with you. She came out without any reference. She passed very well. Admitted to do masters. I said, okay. She did her masters. Then she was allowed to be at that time university, and she was doing her PhD. She continued with the PhD, but somebody, one of the supervisors, delayed her exam PhD there and went overseas. She wrote to me and said that somebody was delaying her exam. I said, why? So report to the university, it is their duty. Let them give you another supervisor, another person, I mean, that person shouldn't just delay your work. She reported and they brought back the man. The man finished with her. She became a PhD holder. I started lecturing there. She was doing very, very well. Until there was a problem between, Madakeke, her husband from Madakeke. There was trouble between him and Madakeke, and that affected her. So I saw that she wasn't safe there because of the problem. In any case, she was wise. She's very wise. She's a wise woman. She's transferred to Ibadan. And that is where she's been until she became a professor. So like he asked, I was never surprised at her, at the pace of her movement. And I thought the sky is her limit. If we were in a good country, I'm telling you, she would have been somewhere. But we are not politicians. Never can we be. Because I don't belong to any group where there is no truth. I can never. No. I can't compromise my Christian religion, my morality, no. But we have to be in Nigeria. Willingly. Whatever comes, say okay. But my daughter should have been one of people who saved this country and a good pattern. But so, what have I said? Her background was good. And she lived in accordance to what she believed. She is a very good Christian. Not Christian going, church going, no. She believes in God. And I told them, say, look, the background of your lives is on this family background, Christian background, where my father promised that she has abandoned the devil and the cohorts. She has accepted Christ wholly and entirely. My father never went to primary school. He didn't know A and B. But he read the Bible, married her, his wife, and taught her the Bible. These two people read the Bible until they were 80 years, 90 years. They read the Bible and believed in it. It's not mine to choose. What do you choose? We always pray. 5 a.m. every morning, I'm up praying, reading my Bible, praying for them. Whatever God says, they'll be there. Because I know wherever they are, they'll be comfortable. Because Book of Timothy, Timothy 6 verse 6, there is godliness and contentment. And there is much gain. There is much gain in godliness and contentment. So, that is the brand of life we have. We are contented with whatever we have, whatever position we find ourselves.